Hey kids, today we are gonna make a chocolate peppermint mug cake.
It's YouTube's best for creative things. It's cooking and crafting.
I am going to attempt to make it gluten-free because I have been asked by many people, hi Paige, to do a gluten-free recipe or two, and I wrote to my friends here at Bob's Red Mill and telling them that I was looking forward to trying to do some gluten-free things with you know, for you folks, and they went ahead and they sent me some samples. So I'm gonna go ahead and attempt from help me out and correct me if I'm wrong, but I tried to brush up on what would be included in a gluten-free diet, and it was my understanding, of course, the gluten-free flour. So I am starting out with a 16-ounce microwave safe coffee mug, and this is the 4 tablespoons of the all-purpose gluten-free flour that Bob's Red Mill sent to me. And I understand that you can use sugar, but it has to be raw sugar, I guess. So I went ahead and I have this sugar in the raw, the turbinado sugar. I'm hoping that it's going to dissolve with the liquids that I'm going to be putting in there. If not, oh well, it might be a little crunchy. We'll see. It's all going to be just a test. You don't have to do this gluten-free. You can use regular all-purpose flour. Here is 3 tablespoons of unsweetened cocoa powder. And we also have 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Now, this is the dry stuff. And I always have issues when I start adding in the wet stuff. So I'm gonna do just a little bit of mixing to make sure that everything is just at least a little combined here. I'm gonna move you in just a tad. Oops, wrong way. There we go. And I am then going to add in 3 tablespoons of buttermilk or regular milk. Regular milk works fine, okay? And then we're gonna add in, it calls for an egg, but you know what my trick is, right? Go ahead and say it, people who watch. We're only gonna use half of that egg. You can use the other half by making another mug or just make a tiny, tiny little omelet. And then we have 2 tablespoons of hot coffee. And I was going to measure this out, but there's not much more left in here. So a half of a teaspoon of mint extract. I think I'm going to have to open up my other one. And also 1 tablespoon of canola or vegetable oil. Are you guys allowed oil? That's the only part that I was really worried about. And now I'm going to mix this up, but we are not done, because once this is mixed up, I have here a crushed peppermint candy cane, and I'm gonna use only a part of it. Let me just make sure I get this mixed up good. And I'm going to fold in that, or not fold in, but mix in half of the candy cane that I crushed. I'm using the soft mint candy peppermint sticks that, I mean, I love those things. So I don't know. I don't know if it's going to be the same. It might melt while it's in the microwave. And once again, what you're going to do is you are going to mix this. You're going to put it in your microwave, and you're going to set it to whatever it is necessary for you to do it. Mine takes 1 minute. I always go the wrong way. And 50 seconds. So I'm going to go do that. I'll be right back. It smells wonderful. I've let it sit for just a tiny bit. And now I'm going to just put, you know how I like my whipped cream frosting instead of a real frosting. You can go ahead and use regular frosting or marshmallow fluff or whatever. And now we're going to take the remainder of this crushed peppermint that I broke through the bag and is falling everywhere. And we're just going to sprinkle it on top of the cake. And this is when I tell you, chocolate peppermint mug cake. Enjoy. Once again, I want to thank the kind people at Bob's Red Mill for sending me the gluten-free flour. And in a second, I'm going to go ahead and try this and let you know how much I enjoy it. That, my friends, is awesome. Enjoy. I need to add right here, actually, that this plus the flavoring that I put in there is a little minty. So I don't know, you know, if you want to, you know, and I only put in just a couple of drops of that peppermint flavoring. So go easy on the peppermint flavoring unless you really, really, really like peppermint. Enjoy.
Thank you for watching Cooking and Crafting. Before we have to say goodbye.